Hey guys, Matt here from MK-SmartHouse.com, and in this video, we're going to be configuring the hardware in the network. To start off, let's talk about the hardware we are going to be using in the network. But before we do that, make sure you like this video, because when each one of these four videos in the network series hits 100 likes, I'll release the video of setting up the home automation server with OpenHAB 2 sooner than it is planned. Anyway, the modem we are going to be using is the Aeris Surfboard SB1641. Please note, I will not be showing in detail how to set up the modem with the ISP, because it is different with each ISP. This is an amazing modem and has many positive reviews all over the internet. Speaking of positive reviews, the main router I chose also does. I chose the TP-Link Archer C7. So these two devices take care of the basic network, and for most people that's it for the network. But since in my house there are a little bit more wired devices, I'm going to need an Ethernet switch, and that is where the D-Link 16-port Gigabit Ethernet switch comes into play. Lastly, since I want more Wi-Fi coverage, let me rephrase that, since I need complete Wi-Fi coverage, I'm going to use these two Netgear AC1750s. Now you might be asking why I need two more routers. Well, these two devices have an access point feature in their software that allows them to act as Wi-Fi access points instead of routers and extend the range of the Wi-Fi network. The links to where to get all the hardware I will be using is in the description below. First, we are going to reset all the devices to factory settings. So we are going to connect our power strip to power and then turn it on. The modem and switch don't get reset, so we will skip those and move on to the routers, starting with the main one, the Archer C7. Plug the adapter into the power strip and into the router. Next, press the power button in the back to turn it on. Then wait a minute or two until the device powers on and the asterisk looking thing flashes slowly. After, press and hold the WPS/reset button for more than 10 seconds until the sys LED or asterisk looking thing becomes a quick flash from a slow flash. Then release the button and wait for the router to reboot to its factory default settings. Next, we're going to reset the Netgear AC1750. So first, we're going to plug the power adapter into the power strip and then into the device and press the power button into the on position. Then let the device boot for a minute or two. Once it is booted, take a paperclip and press and hold the red button down for 10 seconds. Finally, the device will reboot. Repeat this process for any more AC1750s or access points you have. To finish off power distribution, let's connect the D-Link Ethernet switch to power and the Aeris modem to power, which is just connecting their power bricks to the power strip and then the other ends into the devices. Speaking of power, this power strip is one that has a surge protector built in, which is very important to protect all the network hardware. Now that everything is reset and set to as if it's brand new, let's get to work. To test everything before we install it, we're going to connect everything on a separate table. To start off, let's talk about internet connection. Personally, I have a cable internet, meaning I get my internet from my ISP over a coaxial cable. Therefore, I have a cable modem, which is the first thing we're going to connect. So I'm going to take the coaxial cable from my ISP and plug it into the modem. Next is the main router, which again is the TP-Link Archer C7. To connect the devices together, we're going to be using Cat6 Ethernet cables, and I got some in different colors to color code the network a little. To connect the modem and the router together, I'm going to use a red Ethernet cable. So one end is going into the Ethernet port of the modem, and then the other end is going into the WAN port of the Archer C7. For most people, this could conclude the network setup due to the fact that this could provide you enough Wi-Fi coverage and enough Ethernet ports for all your wired devices. But for me, I require more of both these devices. So to solve the problem of more Ethernet ports, next we're going to connect the 16-port Ethernet switch. And to do so, we are going to take the yellow Ethernet cable and put one end into the first LAN port of the router and then the first Ethernet port of the Ethernet switch. After that, let's tackle the problem of the Wi-Fi. The easiest way to determine how many Wi-Fi access points you need is just to assume where most of your devices are going to be, as well as where you think the Wi-Fi needs to be stronger. So let's connect our two routers that we are going to be using as Wi-Fi access points. The thing about these access points is that they are wired access points, which means they require an Ethernet connection to the network. So the places where I want these to increase the Wi-Fi need to have an Ethernet connection of some sort. And I am lucky because they do, as I want to put one of these access points in my garage, where I have an Ethernet cable ran to, and then I'm going to put the other access point in my room where I have an Ethernet jack that goes to the main network as well. But anyway, for now we're going to use another Cat6 cable for each of these access points, and one end goes into the next available Ethernet port of the switch, and the other end goes into the WAN port of the access point. And that's it for the hardware of the network. You do not necessarily have to use this exact setup as I have, but I have found it to work perfectly for the smart house and transmit data very fast and reliably. In the next video, we're going to talk about the software and configuring all the devices. Alright, thank you for watching, and if you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below, or head over to the mksmarthouse.com/forum, where you have a better chance of it getting answered. Goodbye!